Good Morning Bay Street is a production of TheUptrend.com and is for information and educational purposes only. The views and opinions expressed in this presentation are those of Stephen Whiteside and should not be considered personal investment advice. Always consult a qualified financial advisor before making any investment decisions. To learn more about the charts featured in this presentation, please visit theuptrend.com. And now, here is Stephen Whiteside with today's newsletter.
Good morning, Steve Whiteside here with your daily market outlook for Tuesday, March 9th, 2010. In the pre-market this morning at 7 a.m., we've got futures down across the board, so we are looking for selling at the open at 9:30 on Tuesday morning. Now, yesterday was an interesting day. It ended up being a bearish reversal day. The TSX ran up, tried to take out the previous high, failed. That failure shows up on our daily charts as a bearish reversal signal. And it wasn't limited to just the TSX index itself trying to break out above new highs, but also the energy stocks, the financial stocks, and gold stocks, not in Canada. We didn't get a bearish reversal signal on the TSX gold index in Canada, but we certainly got it on bearish reversal signals on the U.S. equivalents, such as the gold bugs and the XAU, and a bearish reversal signal for the materials sector. Bearish reversal signals often mark market tops, and we're looking for confirmation to the downside. And last week, we received a bearish reversal signal for a lot of sectors and the TSX itself. We didn't see fall through to the downside, but the fact that the TSX ran up and is potentially putting in a double top gives this week's signal a lot more significance than last week's. Now, copper made a high 4 days ago, has not been able to break out above that high, so we're running out of momentum up here for copper. Similar situation for gold. Gold made a high 4 days ago, has not been able to break out above it. A daily close below 1119 on Tuesday would give us a sell signal for gold. For the Horizon BetaPro ETFs, similar situation to the TSX itself, ran up, couldn't make a new high. If you haven't taken money off the table here, you need to take some money off as soon as possible. A daily close below 1740 should kick you out. For the energy sector, a daily close below 715 should kick you out. For the financial stocks, you got to take some money off the table here. Daily close below 1065 would give us a sell signal on Tuesday. And for the gold sector, a daily close below $11 would give us a sell signal on Tuesday. Last up this morning, taking a quick look at Research in Motion. As you'll see on the Canadian chart, we generated a sell signal a couple of days ago, saw a fall through to the downside. And then yesterday, a big reversal to the upside, generating a new buy signal. Now, that was not the case in the U.S. In the U.S., we did not generate a sell signal, so there's a little discrepancy between the two markets at the present time. For the Canadian stock, we haven't been able to break out above resistance. The bottom of the open gap is still holding this stock down. And, you know, what would I do in this situation? Well, if you go to the panic zone chart, the last low risk buying opportunity was off this pressure zone here. We've moved up. We're at the top of the panic zones. There's a 10 printing. Unless I don't have, you know, if I absolutely positively don't have anything else to do with my money, you know, I still probably wouldn't buy anything at a 10 ever. So, you know, unless you're desperate to buy a stock and Research in Motion is the only thing that you follow, then you got to take it. But otherwise, I'd walk away. There's lots of other things going on. We're getting ready to potentially see buy signals in the bear ETFs and start shorting some stocks across the board. There's lots of other opportunities setting up, and to try to chase RIM up here at a 10 is not something I'd be very comfortable doing. Taking a look at the 60-minute charts for Tuesday's trading activity for the TSX, any lower close on Tuesday would give us a sell signal. I'm sure we're going to see that at the open. For the energy sector, pretty well the same thing. An hourly close below 290 would give you a sell signal. For financial stocks, an hourly close below 183 would give us a sell signal. For the gold sector, we're already on a sell signal. An hourly close above 330-250 would give us a buy signal. And last up this morning, for the materials sector, an hourly close above 341 would give us an intraday buy signal on Tuesday. Okay, that's all for Tuesday morning, folks. Have a great day. We'll talk to you again on Wednesday morning.
That was Stephen Whiteside with today's Good Morning Bay Street newsletter. For more information on our charts and services, please visit theuptrend.com.